Now let's look at the relationship between SMT and cache performance. The cache of the core is shared by all of the SMT threads that are currently active on it. So for example, if we have two-way SMT, then the cache is shared by both of the threads. That gives us some good and some bad properties. The good property is that we get fast data sharing among the threads. When thread 0 stores something and then thread 1 wants to read it, it gets to get a hash hit. So any communication between these threads that happens within a short span of time, like we store and then we quickly load in another thread, will go through the cache and have really, really good performance, because the load here will always be a cache hit, assuming that the store happened recently. So the communication now no longer goes through shared memory. Because we have a cache, the communication tends to go through just the cache. But when we have an SMT processor, the cache capacity that we have and its associativity is shared by all of the threads. So if the working set of thread 0 plus the working set of thread 1 minus the part of the working set that they have in common, which would be counted twice if we did this, exceeds the data cache size, we get what is called cache trashing. Pretty much the data no longer fits in the cache and we get a lot of cache misses. If each of the working sets would fit individually in the data cache size, then the performance of the SMT can be and usually is significantly worse than doing the threads one at a time. So we were assuming that when we did SMT, that we will get some benefits from using resources that would otherwise be underutilized, like the issue slots and the reservation stations and so on. But that assumes we are getting similar cache performance. However, if the cache has a given size and threads are written to fit in that cache, then running two such threads, if they don't share enough data, might exceed the cache size, in which case suddenly we have a lot more misses than we expected, and we may pay back in cache misses a lot more than we gain by overlapping execution in the SMT fashion.